Hey everyone, Shawn Clement here, Wisdom in Golf, and welcome to another episode. This one we're talking about, hey, when you have more follow through than you know what to do with, your central nervous system has to dissipate the excess. And in this dissipation, for many, it looks like a helicopter. Don't be afraid of it. Many players in the Hall of Fame, including Arnold Palmer, Bubba Watson, and soon to be Bubba Watson, and Bernhard Langer, they're all helicopter finishers. They're right-hand dominant, playing right-handed golf. And we'll show you the differences between the helicopter finish and the standard, you know, pretty finish. See you in a bit. But before we continue, of course, we would just love for you to join us and subscribe. Put a comment and question down below. I'll be more than happy to answer that. And ring that little notification bell to make sure that you're notified next time we come out with a video, which should be next Tuesday afternoon at 1 p.m. So the question is, how do you get more follow-through than you know what to do with? Because many of you have a hard time finishing your golf swings. And that's because you're delivering your energy at the ball instead of at the target. So first question I got for you is, where should peak speed of the swing be? Well, if you're a hockey player and you're collecting the puck from over here and releasing the puck there, peak speed would be out here. If you were fishing and you were casting your fishing pole, peak speed's over here. If you're throwing a baseball, peak speed is over there. If you're hitting a golf ball, yes, I know that if you put an accelerometer on the club head and you have these engineers analyze where the peak speed is, they'll tell you it's at the bottom. That's only because the ball slows everything down. So if you're swinging through the ball and toward the target, like my good, you know, my favorite player, Joaquin Niemann, does, he's collecting the ball there and releasing the ball out there. Peak speed is over here, and it's way more than figuratively. You see what I'm saying? So your brain has to be out there into the direction that you want to start that ball, and that's where you'll have that finish. And if you look at a couple of our videos entitled Throwing the Club, Shawn Clement, and Throwing the Club Straight, Shawn Clement. So let's look at that for a second. I'm going to use a club here as an intermediate point. And when you throw the club, please go consult those videos because you really want to be safe when you do that. Most of you who throw the club for the first time, that sucker's going left, and there better not be people or cars or anything that's breakable in that direction. So what we typically do is we start off with an overhead throw. Notice, because I was focused on throwing the club into my target here, my brain knew when to let go. So if we did that underhand, notice how I'm still releasing in that direction. For many of you, that's going to start going a little to the left because you're unaware of the differences between how your eyes work face on versus from the side. This is distorted. This is perfect. Have a look at why you can't line up properly, Shawn Clement. That'll explain it. So basically, if I throw the club in that direction, the peak speed is there. Notice where that club came out of my hands. Now, if I throw my club and I don't let go, this is where it gets fun. So I'm going to throw the club as far as I can, but not with a lot of strain. So if I'm playing tennis and I'm making a very solid attacking second serve, my velocity on a scale of 1 to 10, if 10 is my first serve, my velocity is going to be around 7, 7.5, and my effort level is going to be around 3. So I don't want to be swinging out of my shoes and out of control and redlining my engine, because this is not a long drive competition in golf. You got one chance. So I'm going to throw my club in that direction and not let go. So what happens? Well, when I throw and let go, I'm basically letting go of the club right here. If I throw and don't let go, the weight of the club is going to release my trail hand over my lead hand and then rehinge. And when it rehinges for me with a vengeance, then what happens is I need to dissipate the excess so it doesn't hurt my wrists. So I learned, you know, what I used to do is I used to rehinge hard here and it used to hurt my wrists. And then I started dissipating that excess like Arnold Palmer and Bernhard Langer and Bubba Watson when they're going with some good juice. So I got a four iron in my hands here and I'm going in that direction. What do we got the green at right there? 215, that'll work. So I'm gonna throw the club in that direction. So right now I'm just hovering the club above the ball and I'm just gonna focus on my throw. Here we go. So when I'm throwing the club in the direction I want the ball to start, the whistling sound should be heard right about there. One more little tidbit to help you understand that. If I had a bamboo shoot here in front of me and I had my machete, I'm gonna, there's the beginning of the cut, there's the end of the cut, and there's where the tip of the blade catches up to my hand, just like in baseball. There's the beginning of impact, there's where the ball comes off the bat, and that's when the trail arm goes over the lead arm out of self-preservation. So you'll see a lot of that in baseball as well, those helicopter finishes. So I'm gonna go a nice throw, right edge of the intermediate point with ease and velocity. Here we go. So off the ball goes, landing at 220, 222, 223 total, about 230. That felt really easy to do. And did you notice that lovely little helicopter finish? That was 221 carry. And if I wanted to fade the ball, I'm gonna go left edge of that intermediate point. I'm throwing the club in that direction. If I throw from here, I miss. If I throw from here, I top. If I throw from here, it feels like I'm cutting a dandelion stem, which means that the ball is going to meet the center of the face if I throw it in that direction. What's it feel like when I throw it in that direction? It feels about like throw. Ooh, that felt good, Moo. Right over the flag stick. Oh, 226 carry. So just a fabulous sensation. We're staying with the throw and we're predicting contact based on the throw. So go see a video that's really important. It's called Predict Solid Contact and Direction, Shawn Clement. And then you're gonna see also how to put the ball in the way of your swing, Shawn Clement, Golf WRX, because we do these for Golf WRX every week. And this will show you how to put the ball in the way of your throw. And that's what's going to give you the ability to stay with your throw to the target. Then you'll have a follow through. So for those of you who are throwing at the ball, it would look like this. Throw. So if you're throwing at the ball, you're early extending, losing your lag, you know, squaring it up too soon. And because that's your target, then your body stops. Well, I hit the ball, I'm good. My target's been accomplished. Notice the body stops turning. And the body stops turning, well, guess what? The trail arm is gonna collide into your rib cage. And when the trail arm can't go that way anymore, guess what happens? Chicken wing, let go of the club. When you let go of the club, you know, starts to burn holes in your glove and your glove gets all worn out. So if you throw the club in that direction, what happens is the brain's got to go get the ground, use the ground to get your body out of the way so you have access to your target. Look where that's going now. So if I'm throwing the club out there, then it pulls on my shoulder sockets and forces that release. And that release, when I'm throwing far, it's like, whoa, I gotta really dissipate that excess. Now let's look at what that happens in my left-handed swing. All right. So left-handed, let's have a look at a couple of throws. Look at that. Notice how everything is coming out here. Now, because my dominant hand is my lead hand, what happens, and you'll see Greg Norman, Sergio Garcia, Jordan Spieth, those are all lead hand dominant guys who have a tendency to wrap the club with a standard, you know, tap on the back. You remember Greg Norman used a tap on the back quite severely, and you'll see a lot of long drive competitors snap the shaft across their backs, especially those 48-inch ones. Yeah. Oh man, you should have seen it. It gets really dangerous for the crowd when that happens. Yeah. So I got my intermediate point. If I throw, I miss. If I throw, I top. If I throw, I'm cutting grass. All right, let's give it a nice throw in that direction. You see how everything taps across my back and across that shoulder. Whoa, dude, 190 carry. Not bad for a lefty. Isn't that cool? So I'll show you the last couple of shots right after this. And you know, just center face. Look at that, 188 carry. Wasn't that nice? Right out of the gate. Holy smokes. So same thing, got my intermediate point. If I throw, it feels like I'm gonna cut grass, fantastic. What's it feel like when I'm throwing left of that intermediate point in that direction? Here we go. All right, let's have a look at that. Come on. So, see, nice 9 degree from the inside. My face was 6 degrees closed. A little bit more of a draw, but look at those last couple of shots. Dead nut center, right in the center of that face. Nice little downward angle of attack. Club head speed on that, 96 miles an hour, because I'm throwing the club. And look at the carry, 188 and 189. So if we go to the table here, so here are my carries on those two four irons that we did, 221 and 223, 188, 189. So notice how I got the same distance both sides of the golf ball with that the same club, because I learned how to throw the club properly on both sides. It's very, very possible, and it's very easy to do. How much easier is it than throwing the golf club? So we stick to a simple task. We throw it out into the direction we want the ball to start, and we let that pull and stretch us out in that direction. And then you see for you how that excess and dissipation will occur, because your brain is constantly seeking the path of least resistance. It wants no strain on the body. So then all of a sudden we got this amazing big follow through, and we have this dissipation of excess as we continue throwing into the target. Enjoy that. All the best.